Here is how you can add 3D effects to your images. We start with an empty project, but we're quickly going to add a section element. It's going to be a title and we'll edit the text to be 3D image. We're also going to add a couple more sections, so we click the plus button here. And for the second section, we're going to add a rich text element. And then we go into the third section where we'll add a quote. Now that we have an outline of our story, we can go into the background elements panel. We do that by clicking here. Click the plus button here to add a new background element and scroll down until we find the 3D scene card. Click on that and you'll see the 3D scene editor. You can remove the default model by clicking on it and scrolling down to the remove button. Now we have an empty canvas that we can start adding our own 3D elements to. Click here to add a new element. And we're going to add an image. Now we have to upload our image, and we do that by choosing our image, and then we can go ahead and click Upload Image. Once the upload has completed, you can see the image in the 3D scene. So if we now switch to the free camera mode, we can spin around and see that we indeed have an image here. What we want to do now is to click on Image to go into the image settings. And here, if we scroll down a bit, we can see a section called Convert Image to 3D. Clicking the button starts the process of generating a depth map and a normal map of your image. With those, we have the option to give real depth to our image in the 3D scene. To show the effect, we're going to move the camera so we can see the image from the side. And then we're going to edit the slider called Image Depth. As we increase the value, you can see that the closer part of the image goes forward. Often when using image depth, you might get noticeable edges. One way to get around that is to click on image, go into the image settings and scroll down until you find fade out edges. When you turn that on, the edges won't be as noticeable anymore. Now that we have our image to our liking, we can start adding lights to further increase the 3D effect. In this scene, we currently have two point lights. We're going to edit the second point light, changing the color to be a little bit more red. Further, we'll edit the position, tweak the vertical and horizontal. Then, to brighten up this scene, we're going to add another point light. It's going to be a bright yellowish color. And what you can see now when we start adjusting the position of the light is that it mostly highlights the right side of the image. This gives us the possibility to relight an image, giving us more creative control as well as the ability to dynamically change the light as the story progresses. To get even more dynamic lighting, we're going to edit the first point light and make it follow the user pointer. This will give some interactivity to the reader of your story, as well as further enhance the 3D effects. The final thing we'll do is to make the camera move when we move the cursor. You have to add a new snapshot, go into the snapshot settings, and change the slider for pointer-controlled camera movement. Now when we move the cursor, the perspective changes as well. If the scene is too dark, we can increase the value of the ambient light. Because we've made adjustments to the ambient light and the camera movement, we have to override the settings for the first snapshot. Now we can go to the free camera mode, scroll to zoom a little bit out, and then we can add that as our second snapshot. To preview the animation, we can click on the first snapshot, then click on the second one. When we now go outside back to the editor, you can see that we have a timeline for the scene that we created. We don't see anything until we edit the first opacity keyframe to have the value of 1. Now we can see the 3D scene in our story. The two snapshots that we have are really close, so we'll move them further apart so we can see the animation when we scroll down. The effect looks really nice. The only thing we should tweak is for the animation to last a little bit longer. You can drag the bottommost keyframe to where you want it to be, and there you have it. That's how you can convert your images to 3D, giving them extra depth and dynamic lighting. You can learn more at Instorier.com/learn or on our YouTube channel. See you soon!